clockwise. So if I apply this equation on this free body diagram, so this is a free body diagram, I write, of left hand side. So first, the bending moment due to this force, which is acting upward. So this force will rotate this beam segment in clockwise direction about the cut point. So WL by 2 is a force multiplied by distance x, we get the bending moment. So I write WL by 2 into x. Then on this beam segment, there will be UDL like this, which will be acting on distance x. So this UDL will act downward, right? It will act downward. So it will rotate the beam in anti-clockwise direction. So the bending moment will be negative. So minus, first of all, the total force, it is W into x. So on 1 meter, it is W. On x meter, it will be W into x. Multiply by distance x by 2, right? So this will act at the centroid somewhere over here. So this will act at the center of the load. So this distance is x by 2. Okay. Then this bending moment, which I have to calculate, m minus m equal to 0. Now from here, we obtain the equation of bending moment, which comes like this, m equal to WL by 2 into x minus W x square by 2. So this is the law of bending moment which will prevail in this beam AB. I call it equation number 2. Now if you put equation number 2 in 1, right, we get, I write, put 2 in 1. So if we do this, we get EI d square y upon dx square minus m. Now the entire equation will be multiplied by minus. So I get, this is equal to minus WL by 2 into x plus W x square by 2. I call it 3. So this equation number 3 is your final equation. Right. And we if we integrate it 2 times, we get slope deflection. So I do now the first part, first integration. I write, this is part B. This is part A. So this is part A, part B. I write, integrate equation number 3 for slope. So if I integrate this 3, so this is equation number 3. If I integrate on this side, I get EI dy by dx equal to, now integration of first term, this will be minus W L by 2 into x square by 2. This is x square by 2. Then the second term plus W by 2 x cube by 3. Or it's multiplied by 3. Plus C1, where C1 is constant of integration. Right? So I write again equation EI dy by dx equal to minus W L by 4 x square plus W x cube by 6 plus C1. I call it equation number 4. So this C1, we evaluate this C1 from the boundary condition. I write, apply boundary condition . So now what is the boundary condition for slope? So I have told you in last class also that at the center or at x equal to L by 2, dy by dx equal to 0. So at the center of the beam, if you look at this, where the deflection is maximum. So at this point, the slope will be zero, because if I draw the tangent over here, you get a horizontal tangent. Okay. Now I use this condition over here to solve for C1. So I write EI into zero equal to minus WL by 4 into L by 2 square plus W by 6 L by 2 cube plus C. So X ki, in place of X over here, I put L by 2 and dy by dx equal to 0. Now simplify this. On this side, it is 0 equal to minus W. This is L square into L, L cube, divided by 8. So 2 into 2, 4, 16. So this will be 16. Then plus WL cube upon 48 plus C1. If I simplify this, we get C1 equal to WL cube upon 24. So C1 will be equal to WL cube upon 24. Now, if you put this value over here in 4, I write put in 4 to get the final equation of slope. So I write EI dy by dx equal to minus W L by 4 x square plus W x cube upon 6 plus WL cube upon 24. Now this is your final equation of slope for this type of beam. I call it equation number 5. Now from this equation, you can calculate the maximum slope, right? The maximum slope will occur at A. Therefore, put X equal to 0 in 5. So at point A, X will be equal to 0, right? So if I put X equal to 0 over here and 0 over here, we get the value of, I write EI dy by dx at point A equal to minus WL by 4, 0 ka square, plus W by 6, 0 ka cube, plus WL cube upon 24. Now from here, I can write theta at A, that is slope at A will be WL cube upon 24 EI. So slope will be maximum at point A, and the value is given by WL cube upon 24 EI. I write by symmetry. We can write theta A is equal to minus theta B, whose value will be equal to minus WL cube upon 24 A. So theta B is also equal to the same value, but it will be negative. Okay. Now this is the first part, that we have obtained the equation of slope and the value of maximum slope from this equation. Now, the second part is to go for again integration of this equation number 5 and get the equation for deflection. So, C part, integrate equation 5. So if I integrate equation number 5, on this side, I get EI y will be equal to minus WL by 4 x cube by 3 plus W by 6 x 4 by 4 plus WL cube by 24 x plus C2. So where C2 is another constant of integration, again, whose value is determined from boundary conditions. I write the equation again. I write EIY will be equal to minus WL upon 12 x cubed plus WX4 upon 24 plus WL cubed upon 24x plus C2. So after integration, I get the C2, which I again obtained from the boundary condition. I write, apply boundary condition for deflection now. That is, at x equal to 0, y will be equal to 0. Because point A will be supported point. So at x equal to 0, your y will be equal to 0. If I put this over here, then this implies that C2 will be equal to 0. So y will be 0 over here, x will be 0, x will be 0, x will be 0. So C2 will comes out to be 0. I put back, I call it equation number 6. Put in 6. So if I put this in 6, I get the final equation of deflection. EIY equal to minus W L by 12 x cubed plus W by 24 x 4 plus W L cube upon 24 x. Now this is the final equation of deflection, question number 7. Okay. So from this equation, we obtain the maximum value of deflection which will occur at center. The maximum deflection will occur at center. Therefore, put x equal to L by 2 in equation number 7. So if we put x equal to L by 2, we get the value at the value of deflection at center, which is the maximum one. So yc is equal to minus w l by 12 l by 2 cube plus w by 24 l by 2 raised power 4 plus w l cube upon 24 L. So if you simplify this, we simplify a little bit, simplified W L raised power 4, L cube into L raised power 4. So this is 2 cube means 8. So this is 12. So this will become 96 plus W L 4. So this is 2 raised power 4. So 24 into 16 plus W L raised power 4 upon 48. So if you solve it, then you get the value of YC equal to 5 upon 384 W L raised power 4 upon EI.